As Anjana said, my name is Helena and I'll be your presenter for the Coaches Clinic. So just a little background, I was in FLL for 3 years, and then this is my second year mentoring FLL, and I've been through many project judging sessions, so I have a little background knowledge. So we'll be going over just the overall rubric and diving into that, and just besides the rubric, how the judges judge you and how they go through that process, and then the team preparation, documentation, and presentation that they need to work towards, and then the coach's role through all of this. So first we'll be going over the rules. So obviously there's 5 minutes for timing. This is including setup, but because it's a video this year, you know, you can come prepared and be ready. Then of course, only the information presented during judging is taken into account. So they should work to have that presentation be just their whole solution, everything about that, and not rely on the following questions. And then it's fully student led. So especially for a coaches meeting, this is super important, because they have to be the ultimate leaders in this. The coach's role is more to guide discussions, facilitate next steps, and provide resources, as well as promoting project passion, both during the presentation and throughout the season, because often there's kids who are like, no, I just like wanna work on the robot and everything, but you gotta promote that passion so that everybody can just enjoy each aspect of FLL. So that's definitely the coach's role, which they're not really taking charge, but just facilitating different aspects. And then of course, this year is different. So there's the video format, which would just be you sending them, the team sending in a video for your project instead of presenting it live. All right. So then I'm just gonna give a brief overview of the rubric before I display it, because it is a bit overwhelming. So there's 4 levels that the judges will be like evaluating the team if they are beginning, developing, accomplished, or exceeding a standard. So the beginning would be minimal, and then partial or some completion, a lot of completion, and then they also have a spot for independent judge notes, so it isn't just as quick as a multiple choice. So they would be 5 standards, each covering 2 main criteria, and we will go over them in detail further in the presentation. So this is the official rubric, and it is a bit overwhelming, but we'll go through each aspect of it, and this should be your greatest like friend throughout this process, because this is what the judges are using to evaluate your team. So first, we are just looking at the 5 different standards. So I'm just gonna read them, you can read them, but obviously I've bolded some things there, which these are like those points that the judges will certainly be looking for. And if you take anything away, like these are super important. So first they have to identify, they have to define and have a well-researched problem. The team themselves has to generate innovative ideas even before planning anything, which is emphasized in the rubric. And then they obviously have to create their idea and develop an original idea and also have a model or drawing. They have to share their ideas, collect feedback, and then improve their solution. And finally, they have to have an engaging presentation, and that's something that the judges do look for. All right, so the first standard, identify, is talking about the problem statement and all of that. So it's super important to have a problem statement, because you only have 5 minutes to talk about everything. So it's just a statement explaining like what is the problem, who is affected, and how does it relate to the theme, explaining and just introing your solution. So before you even do the solution, you're talking about what are we trying to fix with this explanation. Then it's super important to emphasize to the judges how much research has been put into this, because there is a standard for that on the rubric, and it's just super important to be knowledgeable about the topic. So within the team, first they can start just brainstorming, hey, like what's fun to them about this topic? I know it's like sports this year and health related to sports. And then they can split up for homework. Let's say they all do different researching topics, because it's super important that everyone does research and then they slowly get to a solution. As you can see in the graph, or in the graphic, you start with a bunch of information, a bunch of stuff to look from, and then slowly narrow it down to specialize it to the solution. And then finally, experts is super important, because it's not emphasized as much as in the rubric, but I know from past years and that judges look for, if an expert agrees with something or you have looked to find a specific expert in the area, it's much more verified of a solution. All right, then the next step is design. So this is where they are planning their ideas and more narrowing it down. So they definitely have to explain to the judges their brainstorming process and selection, and each team or each member of the team has to be a part of this. Each member of the team has to understand why the selected idea has been chosen and have backup for that. As well, they have to document their whole process and really show that to the judges, like, first, this is what we did, then, next, and also incorporate core values into that, because they don't have a specific core values presentation, so they can explain, oh, well, we all worked on this, and then we voted, and then we talked about it, and that type of stuff, so they can really explain how they're funneling their solution. So the coach's role here would, again, be just to explain that that's the process for them, promote that type of thinking, and then they can take the individual solution and all that they do more with them. And the coach's role is separate from that. Then we have create, which here is where they actually start thinking of the solution or presenting it to the judges. They have to have they had a problem statement earlier, and now it would be a solution statement. So this would be like, what is the solution? Like a one sentence statement, making it clear to the judges, since there is not a lot of time. And if they get too muddled with the confusion, too muddled with the solution, it's very difficult. And then it's super important that they explain that it is an innovative solution. That's emphasized again and again over the rubric, especially if they are basing it off of an existing solution and only improving an aspect of it. They need to emphasize innovation. So that's another thing the coaches can like help with, the wording of that and that type of thing. So in their solution explanation and what information they give, they have to explain what it is, how it's going to work, as well as how well it solves a problem, not just why are we creating this. Like, you have to explain all of that. And then this year they do have like a model or a drawing that kind of illustrates it, showing the mechanical aspects of it. And another super important thing is that the solution does not have to be technical or tech-based. A lot of the time kids can get overwhelmed, like, oh my God, this has to be like we're building some robot, something super helpful. You just need to present it in a way, and it should be something that the kids are passionate about, something that they come up with. So the coach should definitely here have the role of like helping them brainstorm what they should think about and promoting that research, but definitely not deciding what their solution would be. And then finally, a lot of younger teams go, instead of fully technical, they decide to do a more fantastical or outlandish solution. And this is sometimes difficult because it's super important to have a clear idea of how this could be implemented and why it's better than current solutions. And if it's some whole outlandish idea, the judges will not reciprocate to that. All right. Then we have iterate. So this is where the team is explaining to the judges how they shared their solution or ideas with the community and the community feedback. So it's definitely important that they have to share it and not half-heartedly share it like, oh, I told a few people. They have to have clear data and kind of identify who their audience is. And that can definitely be helped with, or if the coach can find some resources like, oh, I know like people at work or someone that can be exposed to, and especially during Corona times, it could definitely be something virtual or interactive. And this is basically explaining why, like, this is the conclusion. They're getting the data to prove to the judges, hey, like, the public agrees with us. This is a solution that is needed. And that's super important to just basically persuade the judges. And then the solution improvements, that is super important and, like, explicitly stated in the rubric. They have to have that data, define the conclusion, and then be able to improve their idea. How can they make it even better? Because technically the end goal for the project, if they were to win everything, is for it to be inputted into the real world, and FIRST would sponsor that. So they need to emphasize that. And then we have communicate. So this is not how they're communicating with the public, but how they're communicating with the judges. They need to be engaging. They need to be creative, and they can do a song, a rap, skit, or a game show. They can have just so many different things that make the judges care about their both solution, but also what's being presented. It's not just the same old story. Then they also need to have clear topics and transitions. So they should outline basically what they're talking about, not just rambling on. And then here I have two bullet points, bulleted and bolded, detailed versus wordy. So they should be very detailed in their solution, not just give a brief overview, but they should not ramble on and be super wordy about it or verbose for no reason. It all has to have meaning. As well, they have to be clear and not only simple. They have to simplify it to an extent, but not give the briefest overview, because the judges do need to see, like, what's everything you put into this. You have to convey that to the judges. So the last bullet point, make the judges care. And then moving on, Then they have to explain the potential real-world impact to the judges, how life would be with the problem, how it is now, and how much it would change with the solution. And then finally, making the world care. So this is telling the judges, hey, you care now, and now let's make the world care. Let's input this into the world and really show that passion. Then continuing with Communicate, they also have to have a viewer-friendly format. And for example, like a PowerPoint, a poster board, that type of thing, even though it is online and it's a video, the judges need to have more than just the words. They need to have the proof, the research, all that type of thing. And then as mentioned before, they do have to have some creativity involved in this. And this is something the coaches facilitate, they encourage, but the team takes in charge on, and they also should, it should be memorized. It should be a little bit easier with the video this year, but it should be memorized just to show professionalism and to show that the kids know what they're talking about. And then finally, soft skills. So this is how they're presenting it. And it is a little bit easier once again because it's on video, but FLL is a three-tiered, like, different thing. So there's core values, there's robot game, and there's project. And all of those are part of everything. So it has to be all member inclusive, all the members talk, they are confident about it, just their body language, everything, and passionate. If the people who are presenting it, who developed the solution, don't show that they're passionate, how can the judges be passionate, or even the world? And then finally, they need to show that they're knowledgeable, obviously, that everyone knows what's going on, and everybody was involved. And then finally, the Q&A sessions, which they would normally have after their presentation. This year, you can choose to have a live Zoom question and answer session following, or they can have the questions presented to them, which would be similar to past years. And then they have a few days to create a video answering those questions. So whatever choice that your team picks, they would be grouped together with other teams that also made that choice in their specific qualifier. And then another thing that's different about that is the all category judging session. So this means that while normally questions would be answered for each session, robot design, project, core values, separately, now they're all in one judging session. So you have to be sure that they have a clear plan of what topics would they go over or try to mention in their answers, despite whatever questions the judges ask of them. And then, of course, include all the members in the team. So not only one person answering questions, because they have to show everybody knows, everybody's passionate about it, everybody cares. And then finally, there's two types of questions that judges usually skew towards. So it's either technical-based questions or process-based questions. So the technical is more if the judges are confused about something or they really want to know more about the technical or mechanical side of your solution. Like, how does this really work? So people, this is where the team has the chance to really show that they know their stuff. They know what their solution is. They know about it all in depth. They've done their research. They're still, even though this is not the presentation, they're still proving why their solution is so important. Then there's the other type of questions, with their process-based questions. Here, the judges are looking for more information to evaluate the rubric. So for example, they're asking, how did you arrive to your solution? Or were there any problems that arose when you were doing it? And how did you fix those problems? So this is a great chance for members who aren't as sure of themselves in the technical aspects of a solution to talk, as well as just incorporating the core values once again, because there isn't a separate core values presentation, and saying, well, if a problem arose, like, we did not start fighting, we did not do this, etc. But definitely those two types of questions are to look out for and be prepared for. And there should definitely be like a structure of what you look to answer in a question and answering the judge's question, but also adding a little bit of more input, so that the judges get a greater scope of your idea farther than just the 5 minutes. And that is it. So if there are any questions, I did talk a little fast, I realize. I apologize for that. But you can type them in the chat, raise your hand so Anjana, the moderator, can notify me, or just anything. So it could be about anything throughout the whole presentation. All right, I can't actually see the chat or anything, but if there's nothing, Anjana, we can give a few more minutes for people to just ask questions, anything more coach role specific, because I know this is more of a coach oriented meeting. Otherwise, yeah.
We don't have any questions right now, but if you do have anything that you're unsure about, please feel free to ask. We're here to answer it.
And then if you do think of any questions, there is, after all of the sessions today, there is a Q&A answer session that you can attend about the whole process and everything. And it doesn't have to be based on only specific presentation that you can go to if you think of questions between now and then. All right, if there are no questions, I think that's all that we need to cover. But
we actually just got one question in the chat.
All right, great.
It says, for this year's project, it says to design a new piece of technology or improve an existing one. So the solution has been limited to technology only?
I do think that you should pay attention to the prompt, but I think that that can definitely be taken in different areas. So I'd do more research into that. I don't know the specifics about it, but I do know that I would guess that it's not only based on technology, but you have to, in your presentation, link it back to technology in some way. But definitely probably start with a base of technology if possible, but not limiting yourself to that. But definitely linking it during the presentation. Just to remind you all, keep the rubric printed out. I know there's resources on the FLL website. The rubric is super important. If you don't remember anything from this presentation or need somewhere to go, the rubric is basically what the judges are looking at and what they're deciding from. And yeah, so I think that's basically it. If there are no other questions, I can give like another minute, but otherwise I hope you all enjoyed the presentation. Okay, then that should be it. Once again, any other questions, go to the Q&A after everything. Thank you for everyone who attended. I'm really glad that you could make it, and I hope you learned something today. Thank you for coming.
All right, if you would like to, you could go ahead and leave this meeting.